This is the lobby of the Sagebrush Theater. This art exhibit will be keeping theater and concert goers entertained before shows and throughout intermissions for the next few weeks. The paintings are the work of South Kamloops Senior Secondary art students. Some of them are first-time artists. Many of these masterpieces have made it into a 2012 calendar, celebrating the bicentennial anniversary of Fort Kamloops. SKSS art teacher Jen Kakasi explains.
Well, this is the sixth year that we've run this project. Lisa Yamoka and myself decided 6 years ago that we wanted to publish a calendar with our student artworks, and we wanted to give our students the opportunity to have a real world experience rather than keeping our artwork in the classroom, and we wanted to get out there and share it with the community. So there's quite a process involved. The students, each year we choose a different theme. It always reflects Kamloops. And this year our theme has to do with the bicentennial anniversary of Fort Kamloops. So each student is taking an image from the history of Kamloops and painting it in the style of a Canadian artist. And then we take all of the completed artworks and we bring in a jury of community members, so that us as the art teachers don't have to make those decisions. And so these jury members, they look at all the artwork and they decide which images are most compelling to them, what draws their attention, what attracts them. And they select the top 30 artworks that you see here. And they also select the top 15 artworks that go into the calendar that's published.
First, students studied Canadian artists and found a style that was unique and interesting to them. Next, they went on a field trip to the Kamloops Museum and Archives, and they sifted through hundreds of black and white photos from the past 200 years, looking for an image that struck a chord. Grade 11 student Frankie Ramuno was captivated by this guy.
Well, the picture, when I was looking through all of them, actually my friend pointed it out, and it was just so old and he looked really sad, and I thought that maybe I could work with that.
Why did you choose those colors?
Because I was representing Daphne Ojig, and I noticed she uses a lot of bright colors and earthy colors, and so when I was trying to mimic her style, I was looking at her pictures and noticed them.
Haley Tompkins is in grade 12. She was motivated by the historic significance of this image.
Tell us about your painting. My painting is of a hydroelectric dam from 1912, and I picked it because I think that it's important to show that even though Kamloops is such a small town, it's actually a really big hub for sustainable energy, and I think it's so cool to say here it's 100 years ago and we're outie doing what we're just starting to make a move on now, and that's the more eco-friendly lifestyle. So.
This was Leah Combs' first high school art class. She says she didn't even think of herself as an artist before this assignment. After a bit of a bumpy start, she discovered a talent she'll continue to explore.
Well, initially I had started painting a different photograph, like as my reference photograph, something totally different, a man sitting on a mill wheel in the middle of a poplar grove in Kamloops. 2 days before the deadline, I scrapped it and started again with a picture that my art teacher had actually suggested to me, and it was this one. My painting is of three First Nations children sitting in front of St. Joseph's Church on the First Nations Reserve, probably back in the 1920s. I found that it was easy to develop a connection with the faces of the three First Nations children because I have quite a bit of First Nations history in my genealogy. I tried to copy Tom Thompson, but ended up really swaying to my style for the final product.
The paintings will remain on display in the lobby of the Sagebrush Theater until mid-December. The 2012 calendars are on sale at SKSS or the Kamloops Museum and Archives. For Shaw TV, I'm Shelley Joyce.